The role of the court in fighting crime highlighted during the opening of the new legal year today.
Fern Carey tells us tonight the Chief Justice also spoke out in defense of members of the legal community on an issue of rising public concern.
Despite rising criticism from the public regarding judges granting bail to persons accused of serious crimes, Chief Justice Sir Michael Barnett strongly defended members of the legal fraternity during his address at the opening of the legal year.
I am aware of the criticism that judges have received on their decisions to grant or refuse bail. We are aware that the suggestion has been made at the highest levels to further curtail the discretion of justices to grant bail. This is healthy criticism. We are not immune from criticism. But I believe it is important to remind persons of the principles relating to bail and to the fact that justices do not capriciously or arbitrarily grant bail without regard to these principles.
The Chief Justice noted that judges also live in this community and are aware and concerned about crime. He then explained that judges follow certain principles when considering bail applications, which he said number 50 per week.
That the suspect remaining at large is the rule. His detention on the ground of suspicion is the exception. And even then, if he is not put on his trial within a reasonable time, he has to be released. Quote, the principles are, an arrested or detained person has a right to be released on bail as a result of the right of liberty and the presumption of innocence. This right must be balanced against the interests of the state, that the person does not frustrate the course of justice by flight, interfering with witnesses, or committing other crimes.
He indicated that judges also impose conditions when bail is granted, and if they are not followed, the bail is revoked. Meantime, the Chief Justice noted that the additional courts expected to come on stream next month are timely. However, he had this caution.
I urge members of the executive that in their language, they do not appear to be dictating to the courts how they ought to be run. Whilst I am satisfied that this is not their intent, it is imperative that they do not undermine public confidence in the judiciary by language and statements that leave this impression.
In the end, the Chief Justice said the challenges in the administration of justice will require the commitment and the participation of all parties involved. Fern Carey, ZNS Network News.